We convene the Sabermetrics Super Panel. Vince Gennaro, Sarah Langs, Mike Petriello. Great to have you all back here. It's an interesting group here. Again, Juan Soto has moved to right field. Opens things up a little bit. A lot of interesting players to get to. Sarah, why don't we start things off? Give us your top 10.
Absolutely. So with Soto gone, I have Christian Yelich, number one. No, he had a down year. We've talked about giving some grace for 2020 stats, especially for guys with proven track records. And with Yelich, something that really stood out to me is that his swing rate decreased by almost 11 percentage points. So it's almost like there was something very specific going on at the plate there, which I really don't expect him to do moving forward. Number two, I had Marcelo Ozuna. Obviously, this isn't really a defense pick, but the offense is undeniable, especially over the last few years. Really good expected stats, hard hit, all of that in 2020 and 2019. Number three, I had Eloy Jimenez. The bat that we've heard about very much there. Again, not a defense pick, but really good for the bat and definitely glad with him at number three. Number four, I had Michael Brantley. Five, I had Dom Smith. Six, I had Randy Arozarena. Obviously, very difficult to judge exactly where we're going to put him, but it felt like he needs to be on here, even just recency bias, everything we just saw from him in the postseason. I don't know exactly where he'll be next year, but we'll give him a chance at six. Jesse Winker, I had at seven. Lourdes Gurriel Jr. at eight. Clint Frazier, I had at nine. The defensive improvement, yes, it was a small sample, but seemed to be on the right track there. And then 10, I had Tommy Pham.
Yeah, I'm glad you got Tommy Pham in. He should be in somewhere. He was like where I was struggling. A lot of times that's the toughest choices where 9, 10, and just missed. You have Yelich, Ozuna, and Jimenez toward the top. Arozarena, you're the high man on, Mike. So Arozarena, we're splitting hairs here, but you seem to have Arozarena a little higher than most.
Yeah, I had the same top four as Sarah did. And then I got to Randy Arozarena at five, and it was sort of, I don't know what to do with this guy. Because a year from now, we're going to look back on this, and at five, it's either going to be way too low, or it's oh my God, I can't believe I put him that high.
Five, right.
But you look at what he did in the postseason against really good pitching, 10 postseason home runs. And what I did was I combined his plate appearances, regular season and postseason, played with the Cardinals a little bit the year before too. And he had 190 plate appearances combined, and he had a .444 weighted on base. And if you go back through the history of baseball, the guys with a higher weighted on base through their first 190, there's only 13 of them. Willie McCovey's one, Manny Minoso's one, Albert Pujols is one. Mm. There's some flukes too. I had to put him somewhere, and this felt right to me.
Well, that's it. Are we going to think Shane Spencer at some point? Shane Spencer was slugged 900, came in for the Yankees years back. Or do we think Arozarena, Vince, is going to be this superstar player?
Well, that's what remains to be seen. And one of the reasons why I had him at number seven versus as high as Mike did was because I was a little hesitant. I wanted to really see him do it just a little bit longer. But there's a couple of young guys on this list, Eloy Arozarena and Dom Smith, who I think stand to go up the ladder in the following season. But I got to talk Michael Brantley for a second. This is a guy with a 90% contact rate, and yet he has a contact rate that's the only person better is David Fletcher, and yet he has a 500 slug. You don't see that. You don't see a guy with a 500 slug in that contact rate. Swinging strikes, 4%. He's got elite contact skills, and I think he's unheralded, and I think he needs to really get the kind of recognition that he deserves. And that's why I have him number two on my list.
Yeah, you're way up there, too. Yeah, I did a little shredder on him, and even the defensive metrics are in his favor. He had a hurt quad last year, so he played a little more DH, but we have this image of him always hurt. He was playing DH. It's like, no, he can still field, and you're right. There's only guys Bregman and Betts who can hit for power and hit for that type of contact. You also have, let me get back to you, Vince, Andrew Benintendi. Again, I'm glad that he's represented somewhere here, but the rest of us, no. Your thoughts on Benintendi?
Look, I think he's run into a rough patch. My sense is if he ends up staying with the Red Sox, that Alex Cora will be a great addition for him, a reconnection that he needs. He flourished under him in the past. And I really think going into his age 26 season, despite coming off league average numbers, really, in the last 2 years combined, I just believe that he's got the kind of athleticism that will propel him back into the top 10. So that was my sort of respect call by getting him at number 10.
There's a small sample everywhere. You have Dominic Smith 3, but Sarah, you have him pretty close there at 5. Your thought, is Dominic Smith for real with that power?
I think so. I mean, the biggest thing with him in his career to this point until 2020 was about regular playing time, and he finally got it, and we saw the player that they drafted in the first round, and I just think that that is what we will continue to see as long as he gets that regular playing time. I mean, he had a 165 WRC+. That was sixth highest among qualified hitters, and every time I saw that, I was like, even though I watched every game I saw him during the course of the year, that's really astounding. And, no one is going to have necessarily the spike numbers that we saw in 2020 because there will be larger sample sizes moving forward, but as long as he's getting consistent at bats, I do think he will be in this echelon offensively.
I found room for Clint Frazier at number 10. That's always like, let me get cute with my pick here. But you've got Frazier, you have the high man on Frazier, right? At number 8.
I do have him at number 8. Yeah. It sort of feels like we've been talking about him like forever, right? Dating back to when he was with Cleveland. He only just turned 26. And, you know, he had a similar issue as Smith, and then he just never got really playing time. The Yankees have a lot of outfielders. He's been hurt. What I like about Frazier, you know, a couple of things, really. First of all, he's improved each of his 4 years in the majors, and I like that a lot. His barrel rate is double the major league average, and I'm not going to totally put too much into the Gold Glove. I don't think he's actually a Gold Glove outfielder. Mm-hmm. But a year before, we were talking about, can this man ever play the outfield again? Yeah. Like, that's how wretched it looked. And he really did improve a lot. The eye test, the numbers. I'm in on him being like a decent defender and an above average hitter.
He won the Gold Glove. I blame you, Vince. How did he win a Gold Glove? Brian Reynolds. No room for Brian Reynolds for any of you? Even, it was a two-month season. The year before, he put up the spectacular slash line.
I didn't fully buy into 2019. That's what it is. You look at his batting average on balls in play, and it was like massively historically high. I think he's a good player. I think he's better than he showed in 2020.
Batting average,
but he's not as good
walks,
as he was on team.
Power. You know what impressed me? That he's hit at every level. I like guys who have had success throughout their careers. Are we buying? We're not buying, evidently.
I mean, I felt very similar to what Mike said. I just felt like, you know, he didn't have the proven track record at the major league level, that I gave a lot of people grace for 2020 with. But I would love to have him back. I did have him last year. I remember that towards the end, maybe 8 or 9, 10, mm-hmm. So.
All right, yeah, Christian Yelich, number 1. It's all a battle for number 2. We'll get to the number 2. Guys, thank you so much.